G'day, I'm Adam Hills. Coming up next on Spicks and Specs, Wilbur Wilde, comedian Dave O'Neill, and the controversial Jeff Duff performs an act that would get us thrown off air in America. See you in a bit. Welcome to Spicks and Specs, the show in which two teams go head-to-head over questions of music. Our first team captain each and every week remembers when rock was young. He and Susie had so much fun. He's actor and comedian Alan Brough. Alan's first guest is a music video presenter for Channel V. She's bright, she's bubbly, and she loves her music. Please welcome Yumi Steins. Alan's final team member is best known for his role on Hey Hey It's Saturday, where he regularly appeared alongside a duck, an ostrich, and a goose. We'll let you decide which one was the goose. Please welcome Wilbur Wilde. Our second team captain each and every week spent her life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain came in. It's Triple J's lunchtime announcer, Miff Warhurst. Yeah. Miff's first guest tonight has been feted by Andy Warhol, thrown up on by Sid Vicious, and is one of Australia's most original and innovative performers. Please welcome the one and only Jeff Duff.
Jeff Duffy.
Miff's final guest is a man whose favourite bands are Meatloaf, Cake and Hot Chocolate.
Yay. Hang on.
That's what he asked for in his dressing room before the show.
Hey.
One of our favourite comedians, it's Dave O'Neill.
Yay. Right.
Our first game tonight is called Know Your Product. Each team gets to pick a topic, but everybody will be quizzed on that topic. The choices tonight are tenors, Oz music festivals, music that has been banned, and manufactured bands, or just add water. Alan, which topic would you like?
Well, look, it seems logical to go for Oz music festivals, because, Wilbur, I'm sure you've played at a lot of festivals.
One or two, yeah.
And
yeah.
Yumi, I know that you basically go to every Australian rock festival.
I'm there, yep.
And last year I went to the Hawkesbury National Fiddle Festival.
Yeah.
Well, it didn't turn out to be what I thought it would be, but it was... Yeah,
Oz music festivals. Miff.
Well, I think I'm sitting next to somebody who's been quite controversial in your time, so...
Thank you.
You've had songs banned, haven't you?
I have had a few songs banned.
What like?
When I was with a band called Kush in the 70s, there was a mention of Mana, I think, in the song, and that was...
less disgraceful.
Adam, we'll take banned music.
Banned music it is. We'll start with Oz music festivals.
Okay.
Everyone on your buzzers, let's play Specks and Specs.
Okay.
Your first question for 1 point. The Big Day Out Festival visits which international city? Yumi.
Auckland, New Zealand.
Well done, it is Auckland, New Zealand.
Yay!
Next question worth 2 points. This is footage from the 1974 Sunbury Festival. Your question is... Hello.
We're not waiting for...
Billy Thorpe and the Aztecs were there on one of the days.
Jeff played at Sunbury, and I've driven through it, so...
Yeah.
You played before... You played before Queen?
Yeah, we played before Queen.
And they got thrown off, didn't they?
They got bottled off. We were on just before them.
You've just answered part of the question. The question was, and I'll give you a point for that, but I'm now going to open it up to this side.
Okay.
The question was, which two bands were famously booed off stage? They've got Queen.
I reckon that was.
The Skyhooks?
It was Skyhooks. Oh. It was Queen and Skyhooks were the two bands that were booed off stage. Finally, for 3 points, name the three music festivals that are associated with these places. Busselton, Western Australia, Lawn, Victoria, and Tamworth, New South Wales.
Yes. Tamworth Country Music Festival.
Yes.
So there's Falls in Lawn.
Falls,
yeah, the Falls Festival, yeah.
Yeah.
And what's in Busselton, Western Australia? That's like...
Beer and Wine Festival.
Yes.
I went to that one.
It's lovely, and they have cheese,
yeah,
too.
Good. Yeah.
We'll go with that.
I love it.
Southbound.
Southbound Music Festival, exactly the one I'm looking for. 3 points. On to band music.
Yes. Right.
Your first question for 1 point. In 1975, The Pill, a country music ode to birth control, was banned in the United States. Your question is, who sang it?
John Lydon.
No.
No, he formed a band called Pill, but I don't think he was a country singer. That's last.
Anyone on this side?
Oh, the King Rogers.
Dolly Parton.
No, it was Loretta Lynn.
Oh.
And 7 out of every 28 singles were made of sugar.
That's funny.
Women applauding, men going, what? 2 points. Have a look at this UK singles chart. Tell me the band and the song that's missing. Yes.
I reckon it's the Sex Pistols and God Save the Queen.
Bang on the money, don't you? 3 points on the line for your final question. In the US in 1985, the Parents Music Resource Center, or PMRC, identified a list of the Filthy 15 artists. Name three.
Madonna.
Madonna's there.
Two Live Crew.
Dog.
Marilyn Manson.
Too late. All right, I'll open it up to the other team. You did get a point.
There was a Prince song in there. Darling Nikki was in there.
Prince is definitely on my list, yes.
Oh, I reckon Cyndi Lauper, She Bop, because that was about masturbation.
Oh, that's shocking.
Cyndi Lauper, yes, well done.
Oh, my 2 points
left. Yeah,
yeah.
Well done.
What guilt is what I had fun about? It's terrible.
I would have also accepted AC/DC, Black Sabbath, Def Leppard, Judas Priest, Mary Jane Girls, Merciful Fate, Motley Crue, Twisted Sister, Vanity, Venom and Wasp.
Twisted Sister.
One of the most bizarre songs to ever be banned was the 1964 release of Louie Louie by the Kingsmen, which sounded like this. Part of the song's success was due to a rumour that the Kingsmen intentionally slurred the lyrics to hide the fact that they were obscene. Here's the weird thing. An FBI investigation was undertaken. Oh, yes.
Wow.
It took them 2.5 years, and at the end of the 2.5 years, they came to the conclusion that they couldn't understand any of the words.
Wow.
Now, while we're talking about banned music, obviously, Jeff, this is your forte. You have had songs banned.
Mm-hmm.
You've also been banned from playing on the midday show at one point.
Well, yeah, it was 1991. And at the time, I'd been wearing fairly conventional costumes for the midday show, and by my standards as well. One day, I decided to wear a leotard. And I had this very, very high-cut leotard with fishnet stockings, black boots up to my thighs.
Sure.
Buffoned hair. Really, really bad, ugly makeup. So I looked like a bit of a tart, actually.
Right. It's not my average Friday night.
Anyway, what happened? Just prior to going on, my girlfriend came backstage and started getting me very aroused. Is it all right to say, girlfriend?
Yeah, that's fine. Long as it wasn't Jeff Harvey.
Anyway, Ray Martin introduced me. Ladies and gentlemen, Jeff Duff. The cameras didn't know where to shoot. So they had to shoot above the waist.
Like Elvis in the 50s, you shot above the waist.
Yes, but this is a little more pathetic, I think. And the switchboard after my performance was jammed with little old ladies complaining.
And wanting to meet you.
Yeah.
Disturbing.
Let's move on. At the end of that round, the scores are Alan, Yumi and Wilbur on 3 points. Miff, Jeff and Dave way out in front on 8 points. Each team will be shown two songs that have appeared on a list of the world's worst songs. You have to work out which ranks higher on that list. Alan, Yumi and Wilbur, you can go first.
Okay.
Your songs are Bop by prepubescent 90s band Hanson.
Look at them, they're so cute, aren't they?
And Rock Me Amadeus by Austria's biggest pop star, Falco. Out of those two songs, which one's worse?
Well, Mbop has got a pretty illustrious history from where I sit. You may not know this, but the middle brother, Taylor Hanson, changed his name to Misha Barton and now works on the OC. And the older brother, I don't know if you saw this, but he looks alarmingly like Chad Kroeger from Nickelback, so possibly there's been a bit of a crossover. Obviously, they had great post-Hanson careers.
Hanson thing, though. I mean, like, the kid's not a bad drummer. The others can sing a bit. The chicks love them. They've managed their money well. But here's the bit I resent the most. They're still young enough to walk away and make a life in IT, property or pro surfing. And
Falco, though, I reckon is 1986's answer to DJ Sammy. Do you know DJ Sammy?
He's that... Yeah, there's that DJ. he works with that DJ Kenny and DJ Daryl.
Yeah.
Daryl Sammy Kenny, right. Sure.
They came from Austria, like one of the world's greatest dictators.
Yeah, well, that was one of the problems with that song is the marketing campaign. Mm. And, I mean, it ruined it initially, I think, because they said, from the country that bought you Hitler, here's Falco.
So, which one's worse?
Well, I think that Mbop is the better song, but this poll was taken recently, so Mbop will be fresher in people's minds, which means I think it will poll higher, as in worse, than Falco's.
I agree. I think bikies, voluptuous blondes, powdered wigs and a priest. Normally you chuck in some cask wine and some cough syrup and you've got a reasonable Saturday night for Falco, but I don't think that key is... it just confuses me, that track. Yeah, I reckon it's worse. I reckon Falco is lower.
I'm saying Mbop is worse.
Right, and you're saying that Falco is worse.
Oh, okay.
The power.
Rock Me Amadeus by Falco, Mbop by Hanson. What's your final decision? Which one was worse?
Rock Me Amadeus is worse than Mbop.
No!
Oh, no!
Rock Me Amadeus came in at number 22, Mbop by Hanson came in at number 18 and was voted the worst song of those two. And you know what? If you disagree with the decisions on the worst songs, visit the Spicks and Specs website. You can cast your own vote on the bottom 100 because we are building a brand new list. Miff, your songs are... Mm-hmm. I Think We're Alone Now by Pop Princess Tiffany.
Oh, awesome. Look at that dancing.
You used to do that in the 80s, Dave.
I did. I used to hold back a crowd of all those dudes. And that shirt. It's like you're midday.
Is that better or worse than Believe by Cher?
Cher. She's gorgeous for 86. Well, really, I mean, it's Tiffany. I mean, she did a very cheap film clip just turning up to a shopping mall and filming the crowd and performing.
She was the lady who actually started the whole kind of shopping centre tour. That's yes. How she became famous. Mm-hmm.
And she's singing I Think We're Alone Now in front of about 1,000 people. Yeah. So she's not the brightest person.
Yeah. But I do love it. She did renounce her Christian beginnings because she was very much the good Christian girl doing shopping centre tours and that sort of thing. And she posed for Playboy.
In 2002.
So she shed the image.
So she should have really posed when was at a peak in 87.
Also, Cher was one of the first people to use that oral exciter.
You know, oral exciter?
Oh, yeah.
In the studio. You know,
hang on, are we back on the midday story again? We're going to leave that one behind.
No, we've moved on.
Yep.
This is a recording technique. It is officially called an oral exciter, and it makes the voice waver. And that was the first commercial song that had used that.
It's like yodeling is what you're saying.
Yeah.
So, what's your final decision? Which one was worse?
No, I think Tiffany is definitely the worst song. It would have, surely. Cher fans, however you say it.
They're still around. Tiffany fans aren't really.
No,
so.
No.
Tiffany?
Yeah.
You're completely right.
Oh! That easy.
Believe by Cher came in at number 35. I Think We're Alone Now by Tiffany came in at number 27 and is officially the worst of those two songs. Cher is the only certified female performer in music history to have had a US number one single in the 60s, 70s, 80s and 90s. Wow. She's also the first performer to have had so much plastic surgery, no one can tell if she's in her 60s, 70s, 80s or 90s. After that round, the scores are... Ooh, Alan, Yumi and Wilbur on 3 points. Miff, Jeff and Dave way out in front on 9 points. Oh. I will read out a misheard lyric, also known as a mondegreen. You have to buzz in and tell me the song that the correct lyric is from. Teams, hands on your buzzers. Your first misheard lyric is... Jose, can you see...
That'd be your Star-Spangled Banner there, the national anthem of the United States of America, sir.
That's exactly what it is. Well done, Wilbur. The next misheard lyric. Sometimes I wish I'd never been boiled in oil.
Bohemian Rhapsody Queen.
It's Bohemian Rhapsody Queen. Well done. Yeah. That
was good. You were so close.
You have lovely nail polish on.
Thank you.
Oh. You too.
Your next misheard lyric is, it's a hard egg, nothing but a hard egg.
It's a hard egg,
nothing but a hard egg.
Bonnie Tyler.
It's a hard egg, Bonnie Tyler. Well done. Next one. She's a muscular boy. Possibility.
She's a muscular boy.
And it's a what's the song?
This is not going well now.
You know the song? I'm going to open it up.
She's a must to avoid. Herman's Hermits.
Yes, that's exactly what it is.
Oh,
yes.
See, there's my misread.
So you actually thought it was she's a must for a boy?
A must for a boy.
Wow.
I'm a complex person.
We're not going to daycare.
We're not going to take it.
Yes, that's it. We're not going to take it.
That's all right.
Your next misread lyric. And there's a wino down the road.
You've got it. And there's a wino down the road.
That's Stairway to Heaven, Led Zeppelin.
Yes.
Well done.
Here's your last one. I got shoes, they're made of python.
I got shoes, they're made of
python.
And I'm in control.
You're the one that I want.
Strangely enough, Jeff's shoes are made of python.
Here we go.
And I've got a rattlesnake on the bottom and tiger in the middle.
That's good. Oh, it's good. We can...
All endangered species.
We can...
After that round, the scores are Alan, Yumi and Wilbur on 6 points. Miff, Jeff and Dave still way out in front on 13 points. Round four is called Melbourne Stars on 45. One team member will play some songs using a bicycle-powered record player. Your teammates have to name the song. Wilbur, would you like to make your way to the velodrome, please? Ladies and gentlemen, Wilbur Wilde.
Okay.
60 seconds on the clock.
Okay.
Your teammates have to guess. You're allowed to guess as well. Your time starts now.
Slipping away from you, Max Merritt.
It is Slipping Away, Max Merritt and the Medias. Next one. It was Mammy Al Jolson. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points, Wilbur!
Yay!
Jeff, you'll be riding for Miff and Dave.
Cool. Do you mind if I wear my special riding glasses?
Go for it.
And my riding helmet?
Yes.
When was the last time you rode a bike, Jeff?
I actually rode to the studio today. In fact, this is my bike.
Right, 60 seconds on the clock.
Feels good.
Okay. Your time starts now.
Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy.
Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy. Next song, please.
Let's go to the hops.
At the Hop, Danny and the Juniors. I'll give you that. Next song.
Can you feel it?
Can you feel it by the Jacksons? Nice work. Next.
Listen to the music.
By Connie Francis. Well done. Wow. Time's up.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
6 points, ladies and gentlemen. Jeff Dark.
Yay.
Fantastic.
And no grease on the trousers. That's excellent.
Fantastic work.
Yes. Classical clip.
Jeff, I read about you playing in London in the kind of time of punk at the Lyceum Theatre.
Yes.
In a gig that went horribly, horribly wrong.
It was a full-on punk gig attended by mostly National Front followers.
Skinheads.
The guys with swastikas in blazon on their head. And I just released a single called Give Me Back My Brain. That was my first single. And prior to going on stage, I knew that I was going to be confronted by the National Front. So I went out and bought a big bucket of sheep's brains, because I knew I was going to be gobbed on as soon as I walked out on stage, because that was what they were doing in 77, 78. And there was a mosh pit down the front with all these National Front followers. And the Lyceum stage is actually sloped, you know, for ballet performances, so people can see their feet. So with all the slime and gob and whatever, I was slowly slipping in. And they were pulling, and it was a very high stage, they were pulling at my feet, and they eventually wrenched me in. And I hadn't even got to the first chorus of the song. And eventually I clambered back on stage, and I thought, I'm going to try and finish this song. But I went back and I got my bucket of sheep's brains, and I just stood there, you know, picking out faces, and I just threw these sheep's brains. Brains at the audience.
Yeah, ironic, because the song was Give Me Back My Brain.
That's right. Yeah. No, but this is the irony. All of a sudden, the sheep's brains came back at me.
You got the brains back.
Right. The score check at the end of that round. Alan, Yumi and Wilbur on 11 points. Miff, right. Jeff and Dave still out in front. 19 great. Points.
We can do it.
Teams, hands on your buzzers. 1 point for a correct answer, 1 point off for a wrong answer. Your questions start now. What is pizzicato?
Plucking of the strings of a violin or a cello or something
yes.
like that.
Yes, that's pretty exactly right. Well done. Which Dido song did Eminem sample? Yes?
I wanna thank you.
It's just called Thank You.
It's called Thank You. Well done. Yeah. Well,
shoot.
Have a listen to this and name the tune.
Oh!
Yes.
Come on, Eileen.
Nice work. Which major key has a key signature of one flat?
That'd be your, F major.
Yes, it is, exactly.
Yeah, F major,
well done,
Wilbur.
So yes.
Major key, yeah.
How many Australian artists featured in the top 10 of this year's Triple J Hottest 100?
Go, Miff!
I'm going to take my time.
Bernard Fanning. We Gorillaz, they're from Geelong.
Wolfmother came in twice, did they, in the top 10?
Yeah, Wolfmother were in twice. Ben Lee, you said Ben Lee?
Yeah, Ben Lee.
Ben Lee. You've got Wolfmother, Ben Lee, Bernard Fanning.
I think it was five, though, in the top 10.
Is that your answer?
Yes.
It was four in the top 10. It was Wolfmother, Ben Lee, Bernard Fanning, and End of Fashion. What is a bumbass?
Not a type of fish?
No.
Some sort of fruit-devouring...
It's a sort of stringed instrument.
It's a traditional one-stringed European folk instrument.
Yeah.
I've heard bumbass.
Final question. Who am I? I'm a Melbourne-based rock band. I'm one of the finest proponents of Australian rock. I've released an album called Hi-Fi Way. Who am I?
You am I.
Yes, bang on, it's you am I. At the end of the rounds, the scores are Alan, Yumi and Wilbur were on 16 points. Miff, Jeff and Dave won the day with 19 points. Would you please thank all our guests for tonight, Yumi Steins, Wilbur Wilde, Jeff Duff and Dave O'Neill. And of course, our two team captains, Alan Brough and Miff Warhurst. We leave you tonight with the most controversial ending we've ever had on Spicks and Specks. Earlier in the show, Jeff Duff told us about the time he was banned from the midday show for a, quote, wardrobe malfunction. We also talked about the 60s song Louie Louie, which is still banned in some states in America. Tonight, Jeff Duff will close the show by singing his letter of apology to Ray Martin while a band plays Louie Louie. Thanks for watching Spicks and Specks. My name's Adam Hills. Good night, Australia.
Here's my story, sad but true, about my wardrobe malfunction that suddenly grew. After many complaints, I received the sackage, 'cause I couldn't hide my manly package. So excited. as a bit of fun. I was singing on radio show back in 1991, but I neglected a minor costume correction, cause all eyes were focused on my small god selection. Raymond, my friend, it won't happen again. I'm so sorry, Ray. Was something I didn't figure, cause the little old ladies, they wanted to see something much bigger. Raymond, my friend, it won't happen again. I'm so sorry, Ray. I got so excited, I won't be invited back on your show.
Don't forget to visit the Spicks and Specs website. There are behind-the-scenes photos. You can email us, and you can also get all the details you need on our guests. We'll see you there.